This is R.D. Sharma's solution, class 11, chapter 29, limits. Exercise is 29.5. Next is question number 9. Here it is said, if limit x tends to 3, x to the power n minus 3 to the power n by x minus 3 equals 108. Find the value of n. What is the value of n? So 108, let us make the factor of this so that we can equate with the solution which we get from the evaluation of the left hand side. We know n a to the power n minus 1 we have to do. What is n here? N a is 3, n minus 1, and this equals 108. So 108, 3 should come, you know, we'll take 3. So 108, we have just normal factorization I am doing. You know, initially when we learned about x factorization, how did we do this? The same thing we are doing it. So 254 times 2 to the 4, 2 7s are 14. And then we have 3, 9, 3 is 27, and 3 3s are 9. So what do we have? This 2 2 is 4. And 3 raised power 3. So we can equate it with 4 into 3 raised 3. Now if we equate, n is 4, and what is n minus 1? Because 3 raised power n minus 1 is 3 raised 3. So n minus 1 is 3. So n will be what? 4. So n has to be 4 because we are getting it from the first relation, n equal to 4, and n minus 1 equals 3. So n is 4 here. Question number 10 it is. So limit x tends to minus 1. X cube plus 1 by x plus 1. So this type of question we have already done. So we have to write it in the negative form. Why? X cube minus of minus 1. Because we don't have any formula for x for plus. We have for negative, which we have been doing. So x minus of minus 1 here. So x cube minus 1 whole cube. And x minus minus 1, we can have a formula, but x plus 1 and x cube plus 1, x plus 1, we don't have any formula. Negative, we have a formula. So a cube minus b cube it is. The limit is x tending to minus 1. So n a to the power n minus 1, what is this? 3 minus 1 to the power 3 minus 1. So that is 2. Minus 1 square is what? 1. So 3 into 1 is 1. 3 is the answer. Question number 11 it is. So x 2 by 3 minus a 2 by 3, denominator will be x 3 by 4 minus a 3 by 4. So we have done this question already. So what we will do? We will take the numerator denominator separately. We will try to insert certain thing which cancels out, but it will make the numerator and denominator to be evaluated. Okay. So x to the power 2 by 3 minus a power 2 by 3 divided by, I'll just write something. First see this x 3 by 4 minus a 3 by 4. The handwriting of mine is very good, so don't go to it. It's very beautiful. So yeah, limit x tends to a. Now I am inserting this x minus a in numerator denominator because they are going to cancel it anyways. So now we'll just use the formula. So you have n a to the power n minus 1, 2 by 3, a to the power n minus 1, 2 by 3 minus 1 is what? Is minus 1 by 3. And what about this one, second one? This is the formula for x to the power n minus a to the power n by x minus a. The second one which you see, we will write the answer in the denominator. Answer in the denominator. This is x minus a, so this second one. So n a to the power n minus 1, 3 by 4. A to the power 3 by 4 minus 1. So 3 minus 4 by 1. Minus 1 by 4. Okay. So now this both we have utilized. So this is 2 by 3 and by 3 by 4. So it goes up. It will be 8 by 9. The constant term will be 8 by 9. What about A? A to the power minus 1 by 3. And I'm taking A as 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3. This we have to use. So 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3, let me tell you again that n a to the power n minus 1 we have used, and we have dealt these numerator denominator separately, so that we can apply the formula, which we know. So a raised to the power minus 1 by 3 has come, a raised to the power 1 by 4 come, which has come from the denominator, because it was basically 1 by a to the power minus 1 by 4 and we took it in the numerator. So it is a 1 by 4, 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3, that is the final one. 8 by 9 is of course the constant value. So 3 minus 4 by 4, 3 is 12, so minus 1 by 12 it is. 8 by 9, and you have a raised to the power minus 1 by 12. Okay. Question number 12 it is. Now this question is NCERT question. So x raised 15 minus 1, and denominator will take it separately, x raised 10 minus 1. So x 15 minus 1, you can assume it to be 1 raised 15, and this 1 raised 10, because 1 raised anything is going to be 1 only. So now I am adding x minus 1, numerator, denominator, x minus 1. So you have limit x tends to 1, Now 1 is okay, otherwise is inverse. So we will write the answer in the denominator. So n a to the power n minus 1, 15, 1 to the power of 15 minus 1. For the denominator or for the second one, it will come in the denominator. You have 10 and 1 to the power 10 minus 1. As I said, anything to the power 1 will always remain 1. So you have 15 by 10, but that is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 it is. Question number 13 it is. And question number 13 till 16, they are almost similar, because as I said, this question number 12 was NCERT question. Okay. So all the questions we have done, you might find it easy because we have already done this kind of questions earlier. So question number 13 it is. X to the power 9 minus a to the power 9 by x minus a, limit x tends to a is 9. So we will directly use the formula and equate it to 9 and try to find out what is a. So what is the formula here? Evaluation. And 9 a to the power 9 minus 1, that is 9 a to the power 8, and this equals a 9. Now divide 9 both sides, you will get a to the power 8 is 1. Now you will be tempted to answer, because anything to the power 8 is 1, that is it has to be, a has to be 1. But we know that minus 1 to the power odd is minus, minus 1 to the power even is even. That means the a can be minus 1, it can be minus, can be plus 1 also. It can be minus 1, it can be plus 1 also, because minus 1 is plus, and plus 1 is also plus 1. Okay. So, a to the power 8 equals 1, and this minus 1 to the power odd, that will give you a negative 1. Minus 1 to the power odd. So, minus 1, minus 1, because we are multiplying it in even times. So, it is by this logic, a can be minus 1, a can be plus 1 also. Okay, so a you are going to write plus 1, minus 1 both. It can be plus 1, it can be minus 1. 14th also we are going to do the same thing. N a to the power n minus 1, 5 a to the power 5 minus 1, that is 4, equals 405. So now divide both sides by 4. A to the power 4 is 105, 405 by 5, that is 81. A to the power 4, that is 3 to the power 4, 3 is 9, 9 3 is 27, 27 3 is 81. It's equal to 81. But the logic, just assume it to be a, what it will be? It can be 3, it can be minus 3, with the same logic I told you. Because of course 3 is 3 into 1 and minus 3 is 3 into minus 1. So the same logic will come, a is going to be 3 and minus 3, right? Now question number 15 it is. Limit x tends to a, x to the power 9 minus a to the power 9 by x minus a, limit x tends to 5, 4 plus x. Now we will do on the right direct substitution, because if we put x equals 5, nothing indeterminate will happen. So on the right hand side just apply x tends to 5, so 4 plus 5 is 9. What about left hand side? X to the power 9 minus a to the power 9 by x minus a, so n a to the power n minus 1, 9 a to the power 8. So both sides divide by 9, so a to the power 8 is 1, so it is a equals a plus minus 1. Same logic which we did in the 13th question. Now question number 16, so both sides limit is given, so n a to the power n minus 1, we are going to use both the sides. So 3 a to the power 3 minus 1, 2, and 4 a to the power 1 to the power 4 minus 1, 3. So 3 a square 4, and that is going to be a square is 4 by 3. Now a square, as I said, it is going to be plus minus. Like a will be 4 by 3, it will be 2 by root 3. But with the same logic as I said, it has to be plus and minus both. So this is all about this exercise. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.